Good morning, Latas. Hope you're well. And I thought I wanted to share a little short story with you this morning and just what I feel God is speaking to me about. And the story goes something like this. There was this little girl and she used to watch her mom cook dinner. And every time her mom cooked a roast or a piece of meat in the oven, she'd cut off some of the corners of the piece of meat and before she put it in the roasting dish and then into the oven. And one day she asked her mom, "Hey mom, why do you keep cutting off pieces of the meat before you put it into the oven?" And her mom replied, "I'm not really sure, my dear. We've always done it like that. I watched my mom do it. Why don't you phone your granny and ask her why?" And so she did. The little girl picked up the phone and phoned her granny and said, "Hey granny, I watched mommy cooking our roast, and every time she does it, she cuts off a corner of the piece of the meat before she puts it in the dish. And she suggested that I phone you and ask you why." And her granny's reply was quite similar. She said, "I'm not really sure. We've always done it like that. Why don't you phone your great-grandmother?" And so she did. She picked up the phone and phoned the nursing home and got hold of her great-grandmother and asked her the same question. Said, "Great-grandmother, I've watched mom and I've heard that granny did the same, cook meat, but first they cut off the ends before they put it in the roasting dish into the oven. Why do we do this?" And her great-grandmother's reply was a little different. She said, "Well, my dear, when I was growing up, I had a really small roasting dish and an even smaller oven. And if I didn't trim the edges of the piece of meat, it wouldn't fit into the roasting dish and then it wouldn't fit into the oven." And what can we learn from this story? Well, I feel like God is wanting us at this time to ask questions and not just to be doing the same old that we've done before. Barry spoke about in Proverbs yesterday about getting our hearts right with the Lord. And I feel like we also need to get our heads right with the Lord. And often we're involved in things that are pretty meaningless. We just do them for the sake of doing them. Often in business, we're trapped or we're stuck looking for a strategy that we believe we can't get or we don't know. But I want to encourage you guys this morning, as the Father in heaven knows these things. He's got a strategy for everything. He doesn't want us doing the same old, same old. Often in the Bible, we see a David going into battle, but first he inquires of the Lord. Why? Because he knows that God has got a strategy for him that can bring him the victory. I want to encourage you this morning, housewives, moms, kids, teenagers, businessmen, workers, whoever you are, wherever you are, God has got a strategy for you, but you need to ask him. You need to believe. Bruce has preached a couple of times on the throne room and that we can access the sevenfold spirit of God in the throne room. And I truly believe and trust for us as Christians that we can do that, that we play with a stacked deck. What does that mean? I'm glad you asked. It means that we play with a deck that's been preloaded that we win. If for those of you that play cards, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. Don't do that anymore. Stop cheating. I'm kidding. But for you guys, we play as Christians with a stacked deck, but we need soft hearts and we need soft heads. We need to be asking and trusting God for a way to help us move our lives forward after this disaster. I spoke to a friend of mine yesterday. His name is Alan. And I said to him, it's kind of like this. You waited for the tsunami on the horizon to arrive. Now it's arrived. It's wiped everything out that we know. And eventually the water will subside and the beach will go back to what it was. And you've got to decide what you're going to put back on that beach. You've got to decide if you're going to keep cutting off that piece of meat from the roast because it doesn't fit into the pot. When in actual fact, God's got a much bigger piece of meat for you to work with. And I'm hoping and trusting for myself and for my business and for my family that our landscape looks way different when the water subsides. But I want you to trust for the same thing with me. Can I pray for you? Father in heaven, we thank you that you've got strategies that we don't know. We thank you, Lord, that we can access your throne room of grace and your sevenfold spirit. We thank you, Father, that you love us and don't want to bring harm to us. And we thank you, Lord, for this day and that you always undertake for us. In Jesus' name, amen. Cheers, guys.